All right, this is another rousing edition of the Doubleheader, where we talk about the sport of politics and the politics of sport with Mark Shields and David Brooks. So, let's start with Newt Gingrich. Done? Stick a fork in him? Or will he go the distance, Mark Shields?
I am not sticking a fork in anybody this year.
Yeah.
I mean, because we've had a lot of forks stuck into ourselves by ourselves. I mean, Newt finished fourth in Iowa, fifth in New Hampshire. In historical terms, that was enough to make you run back to your day job and pretend you never ran for president. Instead, he gets $5 million from Mr. Sheldon Adelson in Las Vegas. He's now in the Nevada caucuses, being close to his money. And he won in South Carolina. So I'm not writing him off. I think he was wounded severely by both the results in Florida and by his less than impressive performance in his non-concession speech.
Yeah. And he says he's going to challenge the entire sort of the winner-take-all delegate system now.
Yeah, he could try. He has a bad couple of weeks ahead of him, which may be followed by a bad several years. So he's got a bunch of states, even the states that are coming up, Colorado or Nevada, bad states, Michigan, Maine, all that stuff. That's pretty bad. I really don't see, unless Romney says something stupid, God knows that would never happen.
No.
Is it good for the party for it to drag out?
It's bad, actually. You know, we always say, oh, when parties are divided, that's bad. But, you know, Obama's pretty divided with Clinton. I remain unconvinced that it's bad. I think you sharpen your skills. You get to be a little more attention. I never think these things
thing I think that is good for Romney is if Gingrich continues to be as he was Tuesday night after the results and becomes this sort of strident, almost abusive candidate criticizing Romney. Romney is going to look like the soul of moderation and, Mr. Reasonable compared to Gingrich, and that can only help him in November if he is the nominee.
All right, and the sport, no, the politics, whatever, the second part, the sports. So you guys already put your wagers down on the Super Bowl, which is happening this weekend. Yeah. You did.
David picked the San Francisco
49ers.
No, yeah.
Kidding.
Yeah.
No. So you guys both went with the Pats, right?
No, I didn't do that.
Well,
you go with Giants.
He went with the Baltimore Ravens.
What did you go with?
I'm going with the Giants by 12. And Jean-Pierre Paul's going to be the Super Bowl MVP.
Wow.
Those are strong words.
Yeah. They
you
are.
Come up with something?
Strong and wrong.
So your picks?
Yeah, you've got to go with the Pats. I mean, this is the defining career game, the legend game for Belichick and Brady.
Yeah.
Two guys you wouldn't want to have in your carpool, but you wouldn't want to have.
I think a lot of people would differ with you about Tom Brady.
Every
woman I've ever met.
Yeah, that's the carpool to the hairdressers. Yeah, he'd never get out of it alive. But I mean, Bill Belichick is not exactly a fun guy.
Hey, you know, speaking
but
of
he's
that
great coach.
Speaking of the NFL, there was a little bit of movement on the, I think, 300 or so players now that are trying to sue the NFL, saying that the NFL knew about traumatic brain injuries and head damage and
really?
So forth. I think Tony Dorsett even signed in. I mean, it's kind of I know that 60 Minutes did a very nice profile of the commish, but it's kind of a significant topic for
you'd have to figure out how much the players think, okay, this is part of the deal. I understand the risks. And I suspect every interview I've ever read and the stories in Sports Illustrated, which has done a great job, the players, out of false bravado or not, know the deal. And they're making a decision. I don't think, whatever the NFL's fault, they're part of it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that league could be a lot tougher prospectively on using head hits and hitting the head and head-to-head.
Right.
I mean, I think if you set a person down for a season after a second offense of that, I think the word would get out in a hurry. And I don't think there's any question that it's almost impossible to make the argument that doesn't really do damage to the brain.
Right. I mean, how many 85-year-old pro NFL athletes do you guys know? Do you know?
I don't know. I was
11 years with the Packers.
Really?
We don't talk about it.
It's the forgotten.
He was with the literal Packers. He was filling boxes.
I was. We did sausages.
On that note, you know how the sausage is made. Here's the double header. It's Mark Shields, David Brooks. I'm Hari Srinivasan. Thank you so much for your time.